the church. My name is May Otieno. I'm born again and I love Christ. We are coming from Mombasa, JCC, Jesus Celebration Center. We are a big team, but we have come a few of us. We have one brother there and another one here. I think because of time, I'm not going to give them an opportunity, but I'll introduce their names. This is Brother Kevin. He's a very dedicated brother. We serve in the same ministry. We have Brother Njoroge, a very dedicated man of God, and I respect them and I honor them. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Receive greetings from my house, my family, that is, my husband. My husband together with my son, they are well and they are good, and they have told me greet the church in one voice. One as a few. Have you received the greetings?
Yes.
Yes, I heard madam saying that you are many but now you are few. Right?
Yes.
Now it means you are the chosen of the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God does not have to work with a big number. Today I may speak the word, but maybe one or two will benefit from this one. Praise the Lord. It's my prayer that this morning you choose to be that one. Let everyone see me today and hear me and feel that I'm telling a story. But choose to be that one whom the word will benefit. Praise the Lord. The Bible talks of the word of God is likened unto the rains. We know the rains? When it rains, even if it rains that little, the earth will respond. Praise the Lord. You can plant grass and keep watering them using a watering can. They'll not nourish the way they'll nourish when it rains. Praise the Lord. And that is what the Lord says, that his word is likened unto the rains. Whenever it falls, something happens. Praise the Lord. But the ground must be ready to receive the rain. Hallelujah. So today the word that I'm going to speak, I pray that your heart may be receptive to receive this word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm just but a vessel. The word will benefit me as well as it is going to benefit you. Because he does not send his word in vain. He says, my word shall accomplish the reason and the purpose unto why I have sent it. Praise the Lord. And the word that he has sent this morning, if it will find a heart ready to receive, it shall bear fruits. Praise the Lord. Do we have our Bibles?
Yes.
Do we?
Yes.
Lift up your Bible if you have it. Yes. You have the Bible and make sure you read it. Don't just try to have a Bible because it was one of the requirements when you're coming to school. Come with a Bible. The word in here is the weapon, not the Bible as the book. You may have the Bible. I hear some people, they sleep on the Bible so that you don't have bad dreams. That is the lie of the devil. Read the word. Let the word be stored in your heart. And whenever you need that word, the Spirit of God will quicken the word that you have read and the word which is in your heart, and it will work for you. Praise the Lord. So learn to read the Bible. It's not to keep in the suitcase and carry it on Sunday. Sunday, no. Learn to read in the Bible. We're going to read from the book of James. The book of James, chapter 5. James, chapter 5, from verse 13. I hope you know where James is. You're not the kind of people you wait for the preacher to tell you where James is. Or you want me to help you? It's between Genesis and Revelation. Right? Between Genesis and Revelation, you find the book of James, so find it.
Yes.
I've made it easier. It is in the New Testament. Let me help you. I think maybe others are looking at it in the Old Testament. James is in the New Testament. The very last books before 1 Peter. James 5 from 13. James chapter 5 verse 13. It's talking of the power of prayer. And I read. Are we there? Are any of you suffering hardships? You should pray. Are any of you happy? You should sing praises. Are any of you sick? You should call for the elders of the church to come and pray over you. Anoint you with oil in the name of the Lord. Such a prayer offered in faith will heal the sick, and the Lord will make you well. And if you have committed any sins, you will be forgiven. Confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed. The earnest prayer of a righteous person has great power and produces wonderful results. Elijah was as human as we are, and yet when he prayed earnestly that no rain would fall, none fell for 3.5 years. Then when he prayed again, the sky sent down rain and the earth began to yield crops. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We thank you for the word which you have sent unto us this morning. Lord, even as I minister this word, I pray that it shall come forth with deliverance, with salvation, and with healing. We welcome you, Spirit of God, to be in our midst. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I've entitled my message, A Fervent Prayer. A fervent prayer. Oh, the Bible calls it an earnest prayer. What is a fervent prayer? First, what is a prayer? Do we know what is a prayer? A prayer is communication, you and God. And most of the time, as believers, we tend to talk too much and fail to hear God. Communication is between two people, one and another. Hallelujah. So when we pray, we should not always go before God and say all that is in us, and we forget to listen. What does he say? So today I want us to learn about an earnest prayer. An earnest prayer is a prayer of a believer. A prayer of a righteous man. And when I talk of a righteous man, I don't mean a holy man, because no one is holy. Only God is holy. And you cannot make yourself righteous. But the Bible says, we are made righteous through Christ by faith. Praise the Lord. Say, I am righteous. Yeah, it doesn't mean you are so holy that you have not sinned. But God, Christ has made you righteous. And by faith, you are righteous. And when a righteous man prays, an earnest prayer, it produces wonderful fruits. So today I'm here to teach us how to pray. And not only to pray, but to pray an earnest and a fervent prayer. This is a persistent prayer. It is a consistent prayer. You don't pray today and you sit and say, I prayed. Keep praying. Pray again. Pray again, pray again, pray again. The Bible is saying, is anyone of you in hardship? What is the answer? You should? Full stop. Do we have hardships or we don't? We are all in our comfort zones. Everything is okay. No. There are hardships. And the Bible is telling us, is any of you in hardship? You should pray. And not pray once. Don't pray twice. Pray always. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Are we still together?
Yes.
You should pray an earnest prayer. What is it that is a mountain before you? Before David was Goliath, he was a big mountain before him. But praise God, because David was a prayerful man. And when Goliath spoke, the Bible is very clear. It says David had him. It means Goliath was coming out every day to insult and blaspheme about God. Other people could not hear, could only see Goliath. But David had him. And the moment David had Goliath, that is the time he prayed. And when he prayed, we all know the story of David and Goliath. Praise the Lord. So today I'm here to tell you, what is that mountain? What is that hardship? Your friends may see you smiling every day, you're dressed, you're smart, but they don't know what is inside you. It's only your heart, it's only you and your spirit who know what you're going through. But praise be to God, because He is asking us to do what? To pray. And when you pray, God hears. Praise the Lord. It is not enough to sit back and sympathize with your situation. It will not help. But do what? Pray. Praise the Lord. Do you know how to pray? Sometimes you may not even know how to pray. But praise God to the Bible. The Spirit of God is there to help us. You want to pray and you don't know what to pray about. Just tell Holy Spirit, teach me how to pray. I do not know. And the Spirit of God will lead you into prayer. Praise the Lord. So many things happen in the background where we do not see. The Bible says our war is not of flesh and of blood, but of principalities. Things in the spiritual realm do happen. It happened that yesterday night I was watching another movie. It just happened at around 10. These Nigerian movies, I'm not that fan, but this one attracted me yesterday. It was called the Mothers of the Night, the Women of the Village, how evil they are. During the day you meet them, they're the best women. Oh, my son, you've come from school. We hug you and you feel, yes, she's welcoming me. But in real sense, at night, what those women do? Praise the Lord. That's how it started attracting me. I can see even your eyes. You just want to tell me, continue with the story. You hear someone saying that my spirit was taken, I don't know, to the sea. You see someone is sleeping. That's why I'm telling you, you should pray. You never know. Those people in your village, when you're carrying your bag, the schools are open, you're coming to school, they are not happy with you. As they're telling you, Jani Ma says, safe Jani. You don't know what that by means. That's why you should always pray. Not all of them are happy because they're in school. Not all of them are happy that you're about to complete your Form 4. Not all of them are happy because you have joined Form 1. They are not. So you should always cover yourself with the blood of Jesus. There is power in prayer. Learn to pray. Even when you are here, learn to pray. Don't think yourself. I'm not scaring you, but I'm just telling you the reality. Even when you are here, pray. There was another young man who had come from town. Now he was talking with his father. Then his father is showing him the piece of land. You know, he was a son. Now I'll give you this. You see this end, you know, they are talking, the father and son, you know. They are talking, I'll give you this. And then there's a woman passing by. And he's saying, oh, okay. Then she comes close. Oh, my son, when did you come? I came the other day, and even today I'm going back, and my father is showing me a piece of land. And I want to build a mansion. You said a mansion? No one in this village has built a mansion. Wow, that will be beautiful. You mean this? And you know, Nigerian. You mean this big house? And then that son said, yes, mom, I want to build a house. Then he said, okay, thank you. God bless you. Then the son and the father, they went. Then as this woman was starting to go her way, she stepped on that ground. And she said, no one in this village has ever built a mansion. You will die poor and you will never enter into that house. And the woman went. At night, they meet now. They have several mothers. And then they have a mother they call the mother of all who sits there now. Then she's speaking. She's saying, someone has gone against our wishes in this village. And then he started calling that name. I don't know his phone. He came. He called him 3 times and he appeared. That man was picked from sleep. You know, he was sleeping on his bed. Then the spirit went. The body was left there sleeping. And then he was here. They cast, every woman cast that man. The following day, that young man was going back to town. He was involved in an accident. He never reached home. The wife was there waiting. He received a call. And he's surprised. What? That man was admitted in hospital with life supporting machines. The wife sold everything in the house, even the cars. They became very poor. That was not enough. They went for another one. Another young man who was in school, but he had problems with school fees. But because he was working hard, he got scholarship. So he is telling his sister at home the good news. Now as they are happy, hey, I've got scholarship and this and this and this, another woman comes. Hey, I can see you're very happy. What is it? Share the good news. Hey, my brother has got scholarship. And what is this scholarship? It means that he's going to learn free. The government will take care and will take charge over everything. Oh, that's good. That is nice. Yeah, that is nice. Come here, my son. Come here. As he was hugging that boy, he was, that is good. That is good. Something was being released from his hands. The following day, that boy doesn't want to go to school. He's very good, eh? Yes, Why? The sister is asking, why don't you want to go to school? He's just started, I don't know. He ended up being a thief. He goes to the shop. He will send the shopkeeper, I don't know, get me something inside. Then he picks the things on the shelf. Then when the shopkeeper comes back, he pays only for that one thing he's buying. He became a thief. There was several cases, so many of them. But God will never lack a remnant. Praise the Lord.